This used to be Kathleen Udy's dream home, Fort Collins, Colorado. We say used to because fraud ended her dream.
And I pretty much plan to live there forever. But it changed everything.
The Udy's house, her life plans, all fell victim to a Ponzi scheme. Here's one of the convicted scammers, Michael Marshall. And Marshall didn't act alone. Meet his partner in fraud, Gregory Russell. It was a $9.7 million ripoff this coffee company used as a front. Dozens were ripped off, including Kathleen Udy.
It's my pleasure to introduce our speaker for this session, Jerry Rome, who's the security commissioner for the state of Colorado.
And this is Jerry Rome, the guy Coloradans rely on to get justice and to get their money back.
As we investigate investment fraud, so we go after the Bernie Madoffs of the world. And when I say that, everyone knows what I'm talking about.
Jerry Rome doesn't mind bragging. Look at this news release from 2015 touting millions returned to fraud victims. Quoting, our investigative team has done a tremendous job of uncovering and pursuing an ever more complicated and far-reaching range of frauds and investment scams. Sounds impressive. Since 2008, did you know that the Colorado Division of Securities has won $187 million in judgments for Colorado fraud victims and taxpayers? A ton of money. And to hear Jerry Rome tell it in 2015, he could even do better than that. Quoting, I'm confident that we'll continue to see high returns for our efforts on behalf of investors as we continue into 2015. But here are the real high returns, the numbers Jerry Rome has fought to keep secret from you for months. 98% of the money Rome's office brags about, they never ever bother to make sure is collected. And by the way, we know the truth. It's not. Rome was number two at securities when Colorado announced the punishment for the scammers in Kathleen Udy's case. They were told to pay back victims with interest. $13 million or more. But did anyone ever bother to even tell Kathleen the good news?
No. Actually, after I testified in the trial, you know, we have had no communication pretty much from then on, except for the check occasionally.
Let's talk about that occasional check from the state of Colorado that shows up in Kathleen Udy's mailbox. Let me show you how much it's written for. Are you ready? Drum roll, please. $6.
We always laugh about the check because it's so ridiculous. Ridiculously small that they might as well not bother printing it.
It's not funny, really. It's kind of a disgrace. $6? Really? You know how much these folks got ripped off? $500,000. At the rate those big checks are coming, it'd only take about 14,000 years for the Udys to get their money back. And what's worse is that Kathleen Udy isn't getting updates from Jerry Rome's office. She had to find out the truth from us.
Well, I'm so pleased to hear from you because if I ever hear from anybody that has anything to do with this.
We think Kathleen Udy deserves answers. Why is Jerry Rome fighting so hard to keep fraud victims like Kathleen and all of Colorado's taxpayers in the dark? We've been sounding the alarm. Look at our headlines. Dolcefino Consulting has even had to file a lawsuit in Colorado accusing Rome's office with breaking the law just to keep their little secrets. And all because of what started with a simple request to find out how much money Colorado fraud victims ever really got back. So it spent months fighting to get one single piece of paper out of the cold hands of Jerry Rome in the Division of Securities. And boy, the Colorado Attorney General's office could have helped us get the truth, but instead they wanted to fight to keep secrets. But we've got it. Between January 2014 and March 2017, since Jerry Rome took over the Division of Securities, they've won court judgments and punishment of more than $39 million. You know how much money was collected for fraud victims? Just $1.5 million. Oops. We think Colorado taxpayers have a fundamental right to know this stuff, since Rome uses their tax dollars to give Coloradans false hope. Rome's annual budget, more than $3.5 million. It's gone up every year since 2014, even though the amounts of the judgments have gone down. Let's do a little math. In 3 years, Colorado taxpayers spent about $12 million to recover $1.5 million. Glad we finally have the numbers. So is Kathleen Udy. Gregory Russell is still in jail, but Michael Marshall is free and living on a woody acre of land in Wisconsin. Lucky him. Wonder if he got to keep his dream home.
Wish you luck pushing the Colorado people to do their job. Everything they earn should go towards paying off their debts to people that they ripped off.